What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Nurse Bass back with another video, and welcome to the next installment of Mastering ABGs, paid for and sponsored by YouTube, a collaborative effort again to help you guys truly master ABGs to be able to begin crushing those exams, but also more importantly for the betterment of your patients.
Are you listening?
Nurse Bass. Beast mode.
In the previous video, we talked about CO2 regulation and how the lungs helped regulate a homeostatic range of CO2 from 35 to 45 so that we can maintain a homeostatic blood pH of 735 to 745. Now what we're going to be diving to is the second component of pH regulation. So the first one was the lungs with CO2. Our second one is with the kidneys and bicarbonate regulation, also known as HCO3. That'll become important. A normal bicarbonate range, whenever you retrieve that from an ABG result, is 22 to 26. So, what is bicarbonate? Bicarbonate is a buffer. It is a base. Whereas before, CO2 can be thought of as an acid. More CO2, more acidotic you become. On this hand, bicarbonate is a base, B&B, bicarbonate base, and it acts as a buffer. What does it buffer? So it buffers out something called free hydrogen ions. Throughout your blood, you have these little ions, little hydrogen ions floating around throughout your bloodstream. These free hydrogen ions are acidic. They are acidic. It's very important to understand. Whenever our brain interprets us as having too many free hydrogen ions in our blood, it tells our brain we are now in a state of acidosis. Our blood pH is no longer between 735 and 745. Now we're down below 735, like 7.3, 7.2. We have too many free hydrogen ions. So how does our body respond? Our brain tells the kidneys, hey, you need to start releasing bicarbonate. And that's what occurs. Bicarbonate gets released from the kidneys. And how does it help with this free hydrogen ion problem? It literally binds with the free hydrogen ions. And what gets produced is something called carbonic acid. So you're probably thinking, how did that really help us? We're in an acidotic state already. And this bicarbonate is supposed to act as a buffer to neutralize those free hydrogen ions and get us out of this acidotic state. How did that help us if what we've now produced is something called carbonic acid? The way in which it helps is that, yes, we've produced another acid, but it's at that point, once we get rid of the free hydrogen ions and we now have carbonic acid, our body can now take carbonic acid and break it down. Carbonic acid gets broken down into two things. It gets broken down into water, which we can then pee out, H2O, and it also gets broken down into CO2. And as we've learned in our previous video, our lungs can easily take care of that. We'll just blow off that CO2, we'll exhale it. So you can see how we have two very different body systems, our respiratory system and then our GU system, essentially, our lungs and our kidneys. And how they each take care of those two main components, the CO2 and the bicarbonate, and how those two play a direct role in regulating our blood pH. And again, to reiterate, that normal homeostatic range of 735 to 745 is so narrow that it is so important that both your respiratory system and your kidneys be functioning properly. And as I mentioned before, with the respiratory system, how you can have issues such as COPD or hyperventilation from a patient who's having a panic attack, you also have patients who have kidney disease. There are different presentations, different renal issues that can affect the kidney's ability to release this bicarbonate. And if our kidneys have a reduced ability to release this bicarbonate, then you can begin to see how these free hydrogen ions are given rein to run wild, how we don't have the ability to produce as much bicarbonate to buffer out those free hydrogen ions as we need, forcing the patient into a further acidotic state. If you're able to get all of that, and I hope you are, then what we have just done is laid the entire foundation for what we're going to be talking about, the interpretation of these arterial blood gas results. We know that a normal pH is 7.35 to 7.45. We know a normal CO2 is 35 to 45. And we know a normal bicarbonate is 22 to 26. And once we begin to see these results on these test questions of this is the pH and this is the CO2 and this is the bicarbonate, then we're able to understand not only what do those numbers mean, but what is occurring physiologically within that patient that yields those results. I hope this video helped. I hope you're enjoying this series. Stay tuned. In the next video, we're going to be talking about this pH regulation and how it is so important. It's your boy, Nurse Bass, and I hope to see you in the next video. Peace.